Howdy, Universal's Cabana Bay Beach Resort. What a cool and rental place to stay. We have booked an interior family suite, and we are gonna love to give you a tour of that suite and also walk around this hotel and show you all the amenities. And if you're interested in that story, this is George the Fitter Stramber inviting you to come join us. Heading off to the airport early in the morning to hop on the airplane to fly across the country with family to spend some time at Universal Florida so we could experience that wizarding world of Harry Potter. We chose to stay at Cabana Bay Beach Resort, a Universal Orlando Prime Value Resort. This video is going to focus on Cabana Bay with a fantastic tour of a family suite with kitchenette and a full resort walkthrough. After struggling to find some parking, we headed over into this wide open lobby to check in. We were pleasantly surprised with this cool mid-century modern Americana 60s charm. The first thing that'll catch your eye are these palm trees reaching the sky, welcoming you to this Cabana Bay Beach Resort. You will quickly realize that this Universal Orlando Prime Value on-site hotel features a fun retro theme, taking your mind back to an iconic beach resort of the 1950s and 60s. This resort is operated by Loews Hotels. Check-in is at 4 p.m. and check-out is 11 a.m. There is a daily charge for parking, and an overnight guest, it's $21 per night. We requested an interior family suite and requested room close to the lobby, parking, and the resort bus system. They were happy to accommodate us. Following the map and the well-marked hallways, we headed off to our internal family suite. We understand the family suite offers plenty of space for everyone to spread out and relax, but let's go find out. Each of the mini suites features a kitchenette. That's why we chose it, with a mini fridge, a microwave, and a sink. Now you can choose an interior hallway like we did, or an exterior entry if you like that old motel motif. In this kitchenette, though they have Starbucks just steps away in the lobby, you can brew up your own ground coffee on this in-room personal Cuisinart coffee maker, and they also replenish those coffee packets every day. Fearless Rambler's hack number 27 is to always crank up that refrigerator to the coolest setting to make sure your soda, a Dr. Pepper, and other drinks will be as cold as possible. Terry Rambler got busy unpacking the food we bought at a local market. These open shelves and the refrigerator had ample space for our daily breakfast and snack rations. Now a trash can was provided under the sink. Room service took out the trash every day of our stay. How nice was that? We loved sitting around the pub table. It was a great place to hang out, eat snacks, and charge our phones, especially after an epic day at the parks. These family suites offer plenty of space for everyone to spread out and relax. This 430 square foot vibrant retro style suite looked like it was designed for fun in mind, such as providing you with many amenities, like two dial-up telephones. You know, they're single line and have voicemail, just in case you forgot your cell phone. This suite also sleeps up to six, kind of, with two queen beds and this pull-out sofa. Let's pull it out and take a look. So let's go ahead and open up this bed and see how it looks, and we just might use it. It says here, lift handle. Pull out. Now here it goes. That is how it gets set up.
Of course, I needed help from the civil engineer how to handle this cushioned headboard.
Voila. Oh, even a better headboard. That's the extra bed in this room. Hey, for kids? Oh, if you like it nice and stiff.
What?
Nice and stiff as a mattress. Is that more like hard? If you like it nice and hard?
Nope.
if you like it nice and firm? I don't know. Okay, if you like a nice and firm bed, this will be for you, that's for sure.
There is a clean sheet available here in the room, and a very thin blanket and a pillow in the closet. Now, if it is up to me, I would bring an extra blanket and certainly extra pillows. The nice thing here, there's a privacy sliding partition between the bedroom and this living space, including two drawers on each side of the partition. Plenty of room to store your crap. Here's a couple of documents they want us to read. If you're interested, pause it here and read the rundown. As we continue this tour into the bedroom area, there are two queen beds with 100% cotton bed linens, two soft pillows per bed, and this orange disc frisbee thing that you can throw around. At least get it off the bed. On the nightstand, you'll find that second dial-up phone. And look, there's four 120 outlets and this retro analog alarm clock with a snooze. And it appears there's also one USB port. Not sure if that's only a music port or a usable recharging port. Now again, around that closable partition for privacy, there are two full-size drawers to fill with unmentionables, such as my buttload of cameras I take with me. There are two flat panel color TVs, including HD channels and on-demand in-room movies. Fees will apply for these movies, but we found plenty of local TV to watch. Or if we wanted more entertainment, we could go and look out our floor-to-ceiling window and watch the cars go by in the parking lot, or pull back this blackout curtain for more privacy. But as you can see, these blackout curtains didn't darken the room much. But that wasn't much of a worry to us, at least in the morning. We got up so early for that park early entry, the sun never bothered us. This room also has some smart room technology for their automated heating and air conditioning. Since this was a heat wave while we were here, crank up the cold. Now the bathroom area is pretty cool. It's compartmentalized into three portions. We are facing that main vanity area with the commode to the right and the second vanity shower area to the left. Howdy, how you doing? What a unique mirror. Now one of the really fun amenities here in the Cabana Bay Resorts is this attached hair dryer. And everybody thinks this Zest soap is the bomb. It's the cool little details in the room that makes it so much fun. Also, this main vanity has two nice small drawers, you know, to hide those unwanteds. Looking into that bath shower area, Cabana Bay gave us another retro surprise. A blast from the past with that Alberto Feel 5 shampoo and conditioner. Do you realize it was introduced in 1962 and became a 1960s icon for hairdressing? I think it's those small details that make a nice hotel a great hotel. And so far, I've been pleasantly surprised. And they also provide this clothesline to hang your wet clothing, such as your bathing suits, over the tub. And what's really nice is the second vanity. It will help you minimize time, allowing several guests to prep up and get ready for their exciting day at Islands of Adventure.
Okay, there we go. Good job.
Hopping over to that third portion, there's not much to say. It's a separated toilet and it flushes. That's all you need to know. Now let's take a few minutes and look at that main closet. Yep. That light works. What else is in there? Now in this closet, we have another outlet, and that's kind of nice, and a few nice amenities, such as this in-room safe. Look across it, they give us a nice little laundry bag and some laundry instructions. And above this, pillow and a thin blanket for that hideaway bed. There's also an iron, a full ironing board, a luggage rack to stick your luggage on, but just one. This ends our family suite tour. Now let's head out and look around and see what they offer here at this prime value resort. I understand there's a lot of fun things to do here. As we're checking out the resort and planning for our trip to City Walk and the park entrances, the question is, where is the bus stops? Well, there's only one, and it's right in front of the lobby. We found out the buses ran all day long and very frequently, and we never had to wait more than 5 minutes to hop on board. Now, if you actually wanted to walk the City Walk, it's a good 25 minutes on a busy street, so take the buses. Now, what about heading off to Volcano Bay for the day? Well, it's just a hop, skip, and a jump from the lobby with its own hotel entrance right by the Bayside Tower. That's Building 7. We just need to follow this lady. With that early entry, you'll be one of the first ones to get a lounge chair looking over Krakatoa. And then when you're hungry, you can head back to your hotel room within minutes. This hotel is that close. Now looking over from the water park over to the Bayside Towers, it was a reminder that we were only a 5 minute walk to the Cabana Bay Hotel's Bayliner Diner. Now you need to beware, other than your coffee maker in your room, there is no complimentary breakfast here at Cabana Bay Hotel. Though you'll find this Bayliner Diner food court is your stop to a quick and easy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at this hotel. We found this diner to be very similar to a mall food court with several options to choose from. For example, the deli station, where you can order and enjoy a deli sandwich, specially made on fresh baked bread, and other variety of baked items at a reasonable price, at least for a resort. And you head here for your vegetarian Beyond Burger. We frequented the Delizioso Pizza Station, one of our favorites. This pizza station offers homemade style pizza and pasta, and traditional sides to satisfy anybody's appetites, like side salads and breadsticks. They also will deliver your pizza to your room, cabana, or even out to the pools. Now, the burger station says it's sizzling good. It's the place to get those hot chicken sandwiches, cold shakes, and, of course, a variety of tasty burgers. And for us, our daily dose of fries. If you're looking for a seasonal changing menu, look no further than the International Station. For us, they were serving some great barbecue ribs that were slathered down heavily with barbecue sauce. Let's don't forget to put some healthiness into our vacation by suffering through a customized salad from that pay-by-ounce salad bar. That looks green. Before you head off to enjoy your meal in this colorful decorated cafeteria, pick up a refillable souvenir cup. This resort has a variety of drinks you can refill in this cup, such as coffee, soda, Powerade, lemonade, and even slushies. Excluding Starbucks coffee, yeah. You will also find a mug washing station to rinse out your mug close to the refilling stations.
I like this one. Kill it.
Now, talking about Starbucks, they have a full functional Starbucks here, including morning and afternoon snacks like cake pops, danishes, donuts, and other delightful goodies. Different drinks galore. And of course, they have their all-day breakfast favorites waiting for you to purchase. In both the swimming pool courtyards, you'll find fire pits ablazing in the evening. One of the favorite activities to do after the parks are closed is to head over to the fire pits and cook up some s'mores with your family and friends. The kits are available with a reasonable cost in the grab-and-go convenience store, or you can just bring your own like we did and pass out those marshmallows and candy bars to anybody that wants one. And...
S'mores.
Eating s'mores is not the only thing you can do in the two swimming pool courtyards. Now let's look first at the Lazy River courtyard. By namesake alone, there's a lazy river for everyone to use. Being a premier value hotel, the pools at the Cabana Bay Beach Resort offers a first-class experience for all the guests. And this lazy river is proof of that.
Look, we went around the lazy river.
Also in the Lazy River Courtyard, you're going to find plenty of spots just to lay out and get your sun. Now, there are sand pits for the kids and a no-entry pool to splash around, hot tubs, splash pad, and a hideaway bar and grill. Now it's time to relax and enjoy the evening. The bar is a full-service bar, while the hideaway grill is going to serve you up some lunch, dinner, and snacks well in the evening with items such as wings, nachos, salads, sandwich, burgers, and fries. And don't forget those hot dogs, tenders, and of course, PB&Js. Pools are ADA compliant, and they have this nightly movie. They can just sit in the pool, cool down, and watch a fun Universal Studio show. Now let's go ahead and head over to the other pool. It's in the Cabana Courtyard. Yes, with its namesake, it has cabanas lining the pool for rent. But more important, this courtyard also has a zero-entry pool for families to enjoy. There's also a hot tub, splash pad, picnic tables, and this 100-foot-long water slide. The pool is large enough to spread out in. You don't feel crowded. You'll also find by the pool plenty of lounge chairs and another bar and grill, the Atomic Tonic. The bar, again, is a full-service bar, while the grill serves up lunch and dinner. Another fun outdoor activity is to head out to the drop-off area in front of the lobby. I want to point out these vintage cars. The make of these cars were used in classic movies, and that is just dang cool. Driving into this resort, they give this retro mid-century feel. Spend some time and maybe even get a pic in front of them. Like this 1963 Ford Thunderbird that was highlighted in the Twilight Zone's Queen of the Nile. Now let's head over and look at this cool Chevy Impala. It shows up in a 1960s classic film starring Spencer Tracy and an all-star cast of comedians. It's a mad, 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 mad world. One of my favorites. And this Four Countries Choir was a supporting cast member for the Audrey Hepburn and Albert Finney's movie, Two for the Road. Now for me, the sad thing is, as you admire these classic cars, you will see that the harsh weather here in Florida has taken their toll. I wish they would spend a few bucks and restore these cars back to their former glory, fix the taillights at least, and repaint them and buff them so they can be enjoyed for years to come. Now if you think they need to restore these gems, comment below. Now keep open your eyes and look out for these cool informational signs telling us that there's lunch, dinner, and bowling just right up these stairs. Up on the second floor, you'll find the bowling, an arcade, and of course, to be healthy, the gym. Yes, our tour guide here is telling us there's a 10-lane full-service bowling alley called Galaxy Bowl, themed from the 1950s with a full-service restaurant. So get your bowling shirt on and get ready to be dazzled with some disco-colored lights. Polish up your balls, put on some ugly bowling shoes, and bowl away. Now, reservations are required, so call ahead, and they are open between noon and 11 p.m. Now don't forget to get a drink up there. Save an excuse when you get a gutter ball. If bowling's not your thing, then arcades just might be. So go next door to Gamerama. Take some prime time with the family. Learn how to shoot Not My Diamond, so you know how to protect yourself before you go to Camp Jurassic or even ride the Velocicoaster. And now for your health enthusiasts, there's the Jack LaLanne Physical Fitness Studio on that second floor terrace. LaLanne hosted the first and the longest national syndicated fitness television program. The show ran from 1951 to 1985. Within all this health equipment, there's a small memorial of Jack LaLanne's accomplishments. Jack would say, quote, "You've got to exercise. Your health account, your bank account, they're the same thing. The more you put in, the more you can take out," end quote. Now from the second floor terrace, you can see down to the lobby where you'll find the Universal Vacation Planning Center. They can help you out with any of your vacation needs. There's also the Swizzle Lounge, you know, to get you ready for the kids for a week. Yeah, that's a must do. And of course, don't forget to stop by that Universal gift shop to buy everything you didn't want, but for some reason you need it. Yeah, like E.T. to pack away. I think I need another suitcase for all the junk that I bought.
Wow, we really enjoyed our stay at Cabana Bay Beach Resort. It was really a great value, including that hour early entry into the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, you know, so I could use this wand. I want to thank everybody for joining us today. I appreciate each one of you. And if you haven't yet subscribed, please subscribe. Become a member if you'd like to support this channel. And hit that notification bell. Give me two thumbs up, because this is George the Fiddler Scrambler. You want to learn how to play with this wand again? Signing off.